What's up, YouTube? This is Popkid here. I am joined by some fellow YouTubers.
Hello.
That's CringeOfDespair. He's an idiot. I'm IcyShadows. I'm not that big of an idiot.
Great intro, guys.
And I am a cameo appearance.
He's a nobody.
It's Michael Bay, guys.
Yeah, it's Michael Bay.
Michael Bay.
You all respect me now.
Put the dynamite down already. Give me the lighter, Michael Bay.
No.
Give me the lighter.
Put the lens flare
down. Anyway, back on track.
So,
no, lens
guys,
flare is,
all right. We're here. I'm joined by these fellow YouTubers because we all, or most of us.
JJ Abrams, that's the lens flare.
Most of us, at least, plays a game called Destiny. And we're here to talk about the Taken King and what it has to bring us.
I played Destiny. I played it. It wasn't for me.
He got Gjallarhorn on his first Vogue run, and then he stopped playing.
Actually, my first raid ever.
So, yeah.
But yeah.
For Taken King.
They're super mad about that, too.
So, alright. Taken King, it looks pretty good. Like, I know there's been a lot of controversy about it, like with the pricing-wise, and people's upset about that, but...
Well, they lowered the price. So.
Yeah, they lowered it,
and they extended, how long did they extend the gameplay in total?
They said that with story, it's going to be around 7 to 8 hours more gameplay.
See, that's what it should have been originally.
Because, they're basically, this is their second game, which in my opinion, I think they should just include, this should have been their first game on launch. But that's a personal
opinion.
But
you know what happened? They were rushed. I mean, all the titles of that, from when this came out, all those titles were rushed and pushed out the door before they were 100% complete. And Destiny was one of the bigger ones that everyone was looking forward to.
Yes.
And Microsoft did not want to let everyone down. So they were like, use a third of a game.
I know.
Just
so
take it.
It is August 16th and we're recording this. So we're about a month away from the Taken King. And we're seeing the the cinematics, the gameplay, it looks pretty fun.
Seeing all the trailers.
Yeah,
other
everything.
Who got, first-hand look at it and they're playing.
You know, so, I know from when I was watching from some guys that seen it, played it at E3, they were talking when the first mission, you get Eris Morn talking to you, you get Lord Shax talking to you, too, and they're just, talking about... the first mission is basically you're going on Phobos, which is one of the new areas you get to go in. I think it's Strike, basically.
That's one of, it's Saturn's moons, right? One of Saturn's moons? Phobos?
Saturn?
It's Mars' moon?
One of them.
It's Mars.
Mars? Okay, so yeah. And Cabal are there. You're thinking you're in there to attack the Cabal, but actually it's the Taken King who's attacking the Cabal. And they were talking about how story driven it is, which I am glad to see. We're seeing more story elements in Destiny. They have quests now. They have a whole bunch of quest lines, which I'm pretty excited.
Which that confuses me for you, because you say that you're a very story driven person, and I am too. And that's the main reason that Destiny put me off so much, because there's such a lack of story.
Shots fired.
Yeah.
So I'm wondering why.
I thought it was. That's why. But before I got it, I was like, man, the story for this is gonna be awesome. Buy it. I'm like, there's no story.
Well, they changed the story. When they released the first trailer, it was completely different.
Yeah, exactly. I've actually watched this one YouTuber who released what the original story quotations for Destiny was supposed to be, and it was a lot grander in scale. The Traveler was evil. And, there's, the Crow was,
main character.
Yeah, and all that stuff. So, it was a lot different, but then they made it what it is now.
All right, back to the Taken King.
Yeah, but for Taken King...
Oh, let's jump... I mean, I'm staying on the Taken King, but let's talk about the trailer in full. Because the way you guys were describing it, the female talking, who's... I can't remember.
Eris Morn.
Yeah.
Eris Morn.
Eris Morn.
You guys are making it sound like she was blaming you. To me...
She was.
No.
Hold on.
Seemed like she was giving you a warning.
Yeah.
He knows. He knows you did it.
It does.
He's coming for you.
Well, this is what she
was
saying.
You got... You... You just
is,
be careful.
Look, this is what she was saying. She was like, "You murdered his son."
She didn't say it that accusingly. Like,
no, in another trailer, she does say it like,
"You
that.
Got his blood on your hands.
You go off, and you go
you
off
killed him.
You go off the all one. You go off the one that's just newly released
with his own sword."
That's exactly how she's all like, "Jesus, Ares, you made us do it."
Personally,
right?
Oh, by the way, the one that we said was nothing was Michael Bay. It's actually our buddy Jacobo. We're not gonna release his real name, but it's gonna be Jacobo from now on.
We'll leave it at that.
Yeah.
Watch more videos, and you'll know my real name.
Eventually.
But going back to the trailer, I don't know personally. Okay, I was there since the alpha build of Destiny, so I kind of did
was.
My.
That is true.
He was standing over his PS4 controller, just jerking off, like, "Oh, Destiny."
I was helping.
No, yeah, that'll be another discussion, but. So I've seen the progression of this game, you know, basically from alpha to completion.
Yeah.
Heck,
I gave you
the
beta code.
I did.
Well, you haven't seen it to completion yet because the Taken King hasn't come out yet.
But I did all the DLCs, Dark Below, the House of Wolves, so...
Mm-hmm.
That's
here's
what really
what I can
got
say.
Me, because I didn't
here's
want to pay for the DLCs
what I
either.
Can say about this. Personally, I am skeptical.
Mm-hmm.
I would say... Because
you've already been let
so
down
man.
Once.
Technically, right. Now, see, I was a little bit let down, I was a little thrown off, you know, when I first completed the storyline way back in September. But,
of
I gave
year?
It a few weeks off, right, and I got back into it thinking, well, you know, at this point, it's fun just going raiding with your buddies,
yep,
strikes, doing Crucible.
Not even Crucible anymore.
Yeah, well, that's a whole other discussion that,
The gun balance.
Right.
They're changing a lot of things. This is what confused me the most with Gjallarhorn. Okay. The reason that they are selling Gjallarhorn is because everyone, like, they're excluding players from raid groups because they don't have Gjallarhorn. They're upset. They didn't like the fact that everyone was excluding players because they don't have Gjallarhorn, right?
Yeah.
And so they're like, okay, well, we're going to sell it. And then here's what confused me. But they're nerfing Gjallarhorn, so it's not as good as it was.
Mm-hmm.
So then it's like, well, then no one's going to need Gjallarhorn at this point because it's not as good as it is.
Wait.
So it's like...
Are they gonna,
it's
like,
almost pointless.
Is the nerf, they're going to send it through like a patch too, so like anyone that has Gjallarhorn, it's going to be nerfed.
Exactly.
That's spits in
that's why it's like, well, what's the point?
Face.
Then again, they're like nerfing every exotic. Like,
because I'm the exception to
is
the
Last Word getting nerfed? Like,
all hand cannons are getting nerfed.
Like
that sucks,
what did they say about it?
Hand
the damage is getting reduced that they're giving?
The stability is going down because basically, like, Hawk Moon and Thorn, you could snipe people from across the map. They're taking
yeah.
that out.
Damn.
They're going to make it, like, close range is better, farther, it's just going to not hit anybody.
Now, my interpretation of Xur's selling Gjallarhorn is I think they're so confident that the new Taken King expansion is going to have sway, you know, more exotics that are actually better than Gjallarhorn.
Mm-hmm.
I think what they want to do is give players who haven't gotten a Gjallarhorn yet, almost kind of like a here you go, you know, try it out, have fun with
yeah,
it.
Yeah, but think about
here's
the people.
Month.
Think about the people that did that raid over like 50 times just to get the one Gjallarhorn, bashing their heads against the wall. Think about those people, because
hey,
now
just
they're
like
hearing.
Any, that's just
now,
like
no,
any
no, no,
MMORPG.
No, no. Now
though.
They're not only hearing that it's going on sale, theirs, the one they have, it's getting nerfed.
Trust me, those people who have been doing the vault so many times, they're going to be the ones that get the special edition everything, because they complete everything
yeah.
in the game. Also, every MMORPG game does this. You know, think of WoW, for example, with all their big expansions. Things get kind of left behind, new stuff gets infused into the game.
Exactly.
So personally, I think they're getting players, say, have fun for the next few weeks, before the Taken King comes out, and then
I agree.
Welcome to a whole new world. You know,
yeah.
you're gonna inject.
There really might be
dogs.
More weapons that we've never even heard of. Like, wow, like this
I think
is
it's
so
a sign
good.
Of, yeah, I think it's a sign of confidence.
There might be something better
part,
than the Gjallarhorn. Like,
they should have given us the Hawk Moon.
No,
that's the other one that I was trying to think. It's Gjallarhorn, Thorn, and Hawk Moon.
Now you see, I'm a Xbox player, so
everyone. Uses and wants to use.
So like I don't even have no Hawk Moon or anything like that. So
I'm pretty sure
they're gonna give. I don't know how many of the PS4 exclusives they're gonna give to
actually,
like Xbox users and thinking. I know
they're probably gonna give them all.
I'm pretty sure they're giving us Four Horsemen,
mm-hmm.
but I'm not sure about Hawk Moon and the rest of them.
I feel like they are,
but I'm
I
not
think
sure.
Back when the game released, I think it was a year time release for Xbox One. Yes. Okay, I think so you're actually getting Monte Carlo, Hawk.
Yeah, so you should get all those exclusive.
You're getting the
whole suite. And isn't there like an armor set that's too exclusive?
I don't think so.
Oh, the veneer and all that? Or that was for the Titan. You got the veneer set. Hunter, I think you got the Argus. Okay. And Arcus, I think. And
yeah, then, so we might be getting those PS4 exclusive as well.
Now, with that, you don't have to have those characters already. They're just going to give you that armor set and you can
you have to get it.
I mean, like, so you have to earn that set. Yeah. It's just only in that kit.
But once, right. But once upon a time, though, those were green armor pieces and the Vanguard set was green and the exclusive, you know, veneer and the art and stuff, that was blue.
I see. Okay.
Now, of course, they're raising the light level. No, not even light level. They're raising the level from 1 to 40 now.
I heard that it doesn't, when the new patch comes out, when your armor, your level, the level doesn't matter. Being the highest level in the game, that doesn't matter anymore. It's your armor is what makes you strong.
Your light level is going to tie in somehow. They really haven't released how it's going to tie in, though.
The armor and your light is going to be how strong you are. So, you could be the max level, but still be really weak if your light level is weak.
But that's,
let's talk about the Dreadnought, because when I first heard about it, I'm like, okay, that's just the new raid area. So I'm like, okay, you're going to go in it. It's going to be super big raid. And then when I was reading some of the forums on the Destiny app, I was like, wait a minute. You're talking about public events? I'm like, this is a new area. We're going to go into it and we're going to have different parts of the ship that we could land on. And, you're just going to see other Guardians just, chilling out, going through the parts in it.
Also, too, on that note, also, being the Dreadnought, the only new explorable world, new explorable area, place.
You know, yeah.
Now, if you all remember, during Gamescom, they released a little tidbits and stuff of Mission 1 of the Taken King. There was a lot more stuff going on. I mean, I'm talking, you know, at the very end of the level, you know, I think the Vanguard ships were flying in.
I'm pretty sure that was Phobos, too.
That was Phobos.
So, two new areas, maybe?
Well, I think what they said is that you cannot go to Phobos as an explorable area.
But it's
just part of the campaign.
Okay.
And if they're doing it like that, because you remember in the past story, or the past, you know, Vanilla Destiny, things weren't as grandiose in the explosions and the effects and everything because you technically had to go back and, you know, as an explorable area. So they couldn't really, you know, get rid of objects and keep them permanently, you know, removed from play, you know, in order to add to the effect. Well, now,
they can destroy a lot of campaign to
exploration. So I think they can go grander and scale in terms of story, you know, and plot twists and things like that.
I like is the idea is that in, the Dreadnought for sure, there's going to be exotic chests that you mean that, you're probably going to have to find a key to actually open it, too. So it's kind of mixing in what we have in with the wolves thing now, because, you have to kill the enemy to get the key, and then you have to get the chest before the timer runs out. They're doing something like that, but, you have to...
That's awful.
You probably have to come back to it or to open it or whatever. I'm like, that's interesting because exotic chests, does that mean we're actually going to get an exotic every time we open it?
But that probably means that it's going to be either a weekly thing or a monthly thing, so you don't just farm the crap out of it.
Yeah, it's not going to be an hour daily.
And on that note, too, because I also heard some rumors about a new exotic weapon, that you actually have to find upwards of tens of pieces. I mean, upwards of maybe 30 pieces.
I would enjoy that.
In order to put together the exotic weapon.
Is that the future?
Orcs? Maybe it's
possibly.
The thing that's on the cover of the art book.
Right. Now that would be so far, but
that would be interesting if you could do that.
More of a explorer, I guess.
Yeah, because you had to collect the pieces of it. That's like what they're doing. That would be an exotic bounty, basically. That would be a new exotic bounty, and that would be cool.
You feel better because you're putting it together. Yeah, if you do something like that,
you shouldn't have it limited to only just one. You should have several. I'm not saying put in hundreds because that would be annoying.
They're probably testing it out, not just one.
If they release if it goes well and everyone likes that setup.
They'll probably put it more, just be like, I actually collected all the pieces.
But if they do like it, they should have it so any new patch, whatever, or they're just going to send out new things you can collect.
We'll see how it'll be.
Well, because, since, I believe, ever since, was it Mega Man EXE, whatever, was exploiting Xur. And every week, you know, he was kind of giving us a little sneak peek of what he was selling. Bungie actually started actually, I think they were the ones who started adjusting Zer's inventory schedule.
Yeah, definitely.
Themselves. So, what's to say, you know, that they might have a more, you know, physical, vocal role in weekly resets and whatnot.
They have not. Especially Quest, because they're going to have new, I know they're going to have, like, Quest for each of the factions or anything, which I think is really cool. But, something.
So, wait, there's going to be separate faction quests?
Yes.
Quests too for each of the subclasses. Even the original subclasses,
true.
I heard that they're gonna have quests for that. So I'm like, dude, that's gonna be pretty awesome.
Yeah, they're getting pretty specific now.
I know, and I know definitely there's the cinematics for when you find a new subclass, and I'm like, oh, because you had to find like an old thing that's never been used before, and I'm like, oh, dude, that's gonna be so sick, and the cinematic for it, and you're gonna see your guardians like. Pick up that like void arrow,
old,
and it's gonna
like,
be so sick. I'm
just
like,
use the old Zelda cinematic.
Dude, I'm so excited to just use void for my hunter. Like I feel like that crossbow, it's gonna be so sick. It's like Nova Bomb, but just more precise. And it's just like I like the effect. So it's a support class, which I think is really cool because
I feel like that's not gonna be like. Too popular in the Crucible just because it's like support and no one wants to be that guy who's like, hey guys, get all the kills while I just help you. Like, it's not gonna
be
like
it would be good for team matches or like capture the flag. That's when that would be good.
It shuts down your supers. You can't jump, you can't throw grenades, you can't do anything. All you can do is shoot and slowly walk.
That is true.
Like, I actually saw gameplay. Like, he shot his arrow, and then as soon as he shot his arrow, this enemy player came in with no point. He was like, oh, I can't do it.
Yeah, he was in the air, rising up for the pitch.
Yeah, and then he was like, I can't do it. And then he just went in, the guy who did the arrow thing just went for the kill. I was like, what?
The guy got triple down or something, too.
I was like, dude, this support class seems to go. And their new grenade, I love it. It's like, you throw it, and it just makes a wall of, like, purple flames. I'm just like,
that
looks so cool. Like, someone's behind the wall, throw it down, and just like, oh, dude.
I don't know. If you compare that super to the new Titan one...
I'm not gonna lie, Titan 1 looks so cool. Like,
that's ridiculous. You get a shoulder charge, you can throw your hammer, you can hit the floor. And also, I think Jacob said that... When you kill someone, you drop a little sun that like, heals your team.
Yeah,
like sunspots.
Sunspots. That's where they were. Right.
That's just ridiculous.
And it's like, and the perks are like, if you're near your sunspot, you get like
extra bonus.
Yeah, stuff like that.
Yeah.
Like, that's gonna be so cool.
I wasn't ready. Just I was looking at his speaker. Did you say that when you die, you drop the sunspot?
No, every time you kill someone, you drop a sunspot.
Okay, every time you kill someone.
That's going to be so cool. And I know the Warlocks, they're going to just love
the Warlocks. That's just everyone who loves Star Wars. They're gonna
I know,
like,
right?
Yeah. Yep,
Emperor Palpatine style, just lighting everybody.
Execute everything.
Which is good we're actually talking about all this, too, because one of the big updates in the Taken King is going to be the weapon tuning. Weapon tuning 2.0. Let's say.
No, yeah, thank God the thorn. The thorn is finally rest in peace, you green bastard.
Thorn's not even that big of an issue for me. Like, I've never really had a problem. I don't use thorn.
No, I use it all the time.
I use last word.
You use it all the time. You're the worst.
You see, I use
he
last word.
He complains about it and uses it all the time.
And if someone's shooting at me with thorn and I have last word, I kill them before I get the burn damage done on me. Because last word shoots faster than the burn can get
me. I don't know if you remember. I'm talking to Cringe. I don't know if you remember. We played one time. It was on... I think it was a capture flag. And everyone on the other team seemed like they had thorn. Everyone.
That's the majority of the Crucible. But it's basically 80% of all Crucible players have the thorn.
Yeah.
And it made it impossible for us to do anything.
If not thorn, you get the Hawk Moon and the Last Word. Mm-hmm. And of course, Matador, Phil Winters,
and Parker Crash.
Just in case,
the worst
thing ever. I mean,
know what we're talking about, for Thorn, they're reducing the like when you shoot someone, it does 7 points of damage for the overtime effect, and they're reducing and it does not stack up. It's just the first shot, and if you get first shot headshot and then you do like two more shots, then you're good. Now they're reducing it from 7 damage over time to 3 damage over time.
But
however,
it does stack
up. So you get 3 shots, that's like 3, 6, 9. So pretty... I guess that's good. I guess that's better. But
And I guess...
Yeah, but seven over time, even if you get that one hit, it's like... How long does the effect last? It lasts for like...
Seven ticks.
But see...
Yeah, seven. So seven times seven.
But that's the Thor effect.
It takes 49 health right there. Mm-hmm.
But that's the Thor effect. But of course, you know, the whole archetype of hand cannons is going to be dialed down a little bit, too.
That's true. So it's getting like double nerfed.
So yeah, Thorn's getting nerfed and the hand cannons are getting nerfed. It's going down.
When I used hand cannons.
No, it's not
going
to be too bad. It's just the range difference.
Yeah,
oh, but you can't snipe people with it. Like you can't.
Are they gonna buff?
See, that's what made it
auto rifles. Because are they gonna buff auto rifles?
Yes,
because
I'm excited.
At this point, nobody uses
that's
auto rifles.
That's what they needed,
so.
Though.
That is
because I would have used the auto rifle if it wasn't
like,
so.
The only
bad.
Thing people ever use: shotguns, pulse rifles, hand cannons, and nothing else.
I use shotguns when I get when I got super angry. I was just like, I'm just gonna take this tight corner and pop out, and then.
That's just the
right
majority
the
of people use. Party Crasher, Fell Winter, Swordbreaker, just all those like clutch ones. But if anything, I would say they should buff shotguns. But shotguns are shotguns in every game. Like everyone's just like
shotguns don't need to be buffed.
Yeah,
like there are very few instances in games where shotguns like, oh, this needs to be buffed.
Let us go.
So technically shotguns are always
swords.
In games.
Yes. Okay, so
you actually get to use swords? You don't have to be blade
answering.
That's going to be
the new heavy weapon.
There is a new heavy. It's
okay, so it's
going to
be like the special
artifacts.
In the one run, you know, we pick up the guy's sword and you just, okay, it's just
they're called
like
artifacts. You can actually equip them and they actually do damage and they have an ammo amount.
It's a limited amount.
So I'm like,
okay, so it's like a Halo sword.
Looks,
yes,
basically.
Got it.
I'm very happy about this. Like, that's such a cool idea. I can't wait to just hold, like, sword or my own type of sword. Because they were talking about Eris Morn sends you on a quest where you have to find an ancient weapon that hasn't been used for centuries or whatever. And that's going to be the melee weapons, which are... They're going to be... I don't think it's just going to be swords. It's going to be also, like, the Scorch Cannon or something similar to that.
The thing I want, that if you can use a sword, for it to be in first person like it was in Halo...
I don't,
that would be cool. I would like that.
It's not going
to
be
It's not going to. Yeah. That'd be cool.
It would be.
Battlefront 2, when you're playing as the Jedi.
I mean, that's how it is now, though.
But, man, it's going to be interesting, because you're going to... If they're going to, like, say, like, give you new weapons of those type, a new like, type of weapon to equip, you're going to get all types of, like, types of swords that look really epic. Imagine, like, a really mechanical-looking sword that does arc damage. Like, that's going to look pretty sick.
I was
going
to say,
the arc one's
going to
be, like, a laser-like thing.
And looks...
That would be really cool.
And sword needs Firefly.
Yes, right? Oh, my God. Perks.
Hit them once, they just explode.
Perks for these swords. That's gonna be a thing too. Like,
no, I feel like the perks for swords. I think that would be making them too overpowered.
I don't, because you have a limited amount of swings.
So
five swings.
It's the same with guns, because you get a limited amount of ammo.
No, but it's gotta be competitive against a rocket launcher that can walk on
and
across the map.
I mean,
most
of the time though, if you're going up against a rocket versus a sword, the rocket's gonna win if they're far away.
If you don't have blades.
Well, no, even if they're close, because you just have to aim for their feet.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. Rocket's gonna win, but like you have a chance of killing yourself.
Unless, you know, they probably have a trick up their sleeve. You know,
for a fact that we don't care about killing ourselves. We will kill ourselves just to spite the other person. We will launch
the
right
swords,
at our feet, just be like, "Got you, mother."
The swords, though, if they do like a ground effect where you smash the ground and then it travels.
Oh, like when you have the sword,
like arc blades.
Uh-huh.
Like arc blade things when it travels.
You mean like the hammer in Halo 3. Mm-hmm.
When it travels along the ground, or it does a wide area of damage instead.
They'll probably shockwave.
Yeah,
it'll
mostly be something
like
that.
Talking about AoEs.
Yes,
right.
And it does like burn damage, like stuff
now,
like that.
Now, who's
That'd
to say?
Cool.
You know, if they're bringing in swords for, you know, like a proto sword, who's to say they won't bring in the relic from the Vault of Glass?
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Maybe use it as like a portable
something
titan
like
shield,
that.
Like a bubble shield or something.
That would be epic. Because I really feel like the relic is just like the epic version of like a blade dancer for me.
The relic would be like a supportive thing though.
Oh, definitely, and anyone can pick it up and use it. You know, have so many charges.
Yeah, so that wouldn't be like I don't think that would. I'm gonna do that because like the equip thing.
Also,
a heavy weapon. Yeah, I mean the floodgates are open.
But it would be like
it would
be it would be exclusively supportive, and I don't think many people would pick it.
Not the trailer that we just watched, because we just watched the trailer before we started talking about this, but the first trailer where it shows the gameplay and everything, mm-hmm. there's a new person talking. Who is this person? There's a new guy talking. He's not. He's none of the vendors. He's not the speaker.
You're right. That is a new.
He's
voice.
No one from the. He's no one from the Reef. I think
it's the Taken King.
I think
too easy.
That it's Osiris.
Now, yeah, I do. Osiris, Tolan the Shattered, maybe as well, because
Tolan.
Who's
that's
the
a good.
Because there was one person who was looking into the hive, it was, and he through his research created, I think, Thorn or Bad Juju.
Yeah, that was Tolan.
Tolan the Shattered.
Yeah, for Bad Juju, mm-hmm. the exotic bounty is Tolan's legacy.
Legacy, right?
And when you read the Grimoire cards, it talks about Eris and Tolan and mm-hmm. some other characters. They made a raid team to go down in the pit to fight Crota.
To go to the dark below.
Basically,
right.
The others like said, the other people died. Tolan just went insane and just started just went off on his own, and
right.
then Eris Morn basically just survived herself.
Mm-hmm.
Like her,
how many years? It was
oh no,
a while,
it was a while. Mm-hmm. Tolan actually taught her how to use her light to kind of like save her life
mm-hmm.
down there. So she used up the last of her light to like save her life. Like he taught her how to do that.
She was down there, she built that ship, and then she just finally found a way to go to the tower.
But they also.
I know it's a lot of stuff.
Introduced in the gameplay stuff during Gamescom as well is, of course, Ghost, voiced by Nolan North, I believe is his name now.
I believe that's
the new. It's
Nolan
not Peter
North?
Dinklage.
Peter Dinklage, yeah.
Peter Dinklage.
They're both good voice actors.
But I believe the new gentleman, I think his name is Richard North. But
Yeah, you're right.
You can pull out Ghost now and actually scan objects in the environment now. And that's a whole new feature and add a little bit to the lore.
Okay.
A little bit of depth.
That's
yeah,
I'm
it, so.
I'm glad. I'm glad that they're doing that. That's good.
Just little things,
you know?
Make a big impact. So
that's good cuz they've gotten so many complaints. They're actually putting it all in the game now, so.
Right. I was going to say.
Even if it's in text, I'm happy with that.
Okay.
I'm just happy with that. I really want to see it there. It's just like a racing thing. Like I would be happy with that. Like
yeah,
so,
that would be so cool.
I would be so happy just to see her racing with like your things. Like it would make a point to that. So
they would probably do like if they ever get that, it would probably be like an attachment to the tower.
Speaking of tower, there is a crucible match that occurs in the
there
tower.
Is.
I've been speaking with Mask Man, and we were like saying that that's what the new area, like not the new area, but the area by where the speaker is.
No, this is actually an abandoned tower across the city.
Is it an abandoned tower?
Yeah, it's a new tower.
But no, because like we're looking at the gameplay, it looks it's 100%.
I know it's almost identical, but it's a separate tower.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, I didn't know that.
You're gonna build,
I didn't hear about that.
Like hubs in. The same area, you're gonna make them look fairly the same.
Well, of course, the city, we're not really sure how big the city is. I'm sure the specifications
yeah.
were in some of the Grimoire cards there. But the city, I mean, it's holding Earth's humanity within the walls.
Yeah, it's like all
yeah.
of the
walls. It's pretty, it's fairly big.
It is, it does look big.
I'm trying to draw parallels
well, it's
to
not,
Titan,
it's not just Earth's humanity, I mean, it's also all the other alien races that are living
well,
there too.
Well, all the humans on Earth and also some sparse exos and Awoken that decided to. Come chill with us, but well, exos didn't have a chance.
Yeah, guys.
Apparently,
yeah.
humans built the exos.
No, let's go on the last topic, which is the final raid with Oryx. No, now notice this. This is what I've learned. There's going to be strikes that include Oryx in it, and then there's going to be the raid too. So
it's kind of gonna be how like Omnigul was in some story missions.
Exactly.
And stuff
yeah.
Like that.
So I feel it's gonna be like there's gonna be like the strikes are gonna kind of. Or the strikes or the story missions is going to lead you up. The story mission and then the raid. Story mission is going to lead you up to, like, Oryx. Then you're going to have a small confrontation with him.
Mm-hmm.
And the raid, you get to the ship.
He's going to give you a stern talking to. You killed my son, you guardian. I'm going to kick your butt. And he's just going to point his finger.
You know what? We're going to say, bring it on, Oryx. Okay, when you want to go. Like,
see, that's when he gets pissed and tries to kill you.
And then that's when...
No, the thing I want to see is how basically every boss so far, they have a certain pattern. They're just like, hey, I have one attack. And then I'm going to move this way. And all my little guys are going to attack you. You kill all of them. Okay, you can hit me like two or three times. Then I'm going to do my one attack again. Then move to the side a little bit. Summon more
mm-hmm.
dudes. So I
that's
want him
right.
to have like
you
multiple different attacks. Because this is just...
You know what I want?
It just kind of sucks, in my opinion. They're all just very
They said it's going to be their newest, hardest raid ever, so
and plus,
we'll see.
In
we'll
the house
see
of
how hard.
Skolas, all he does, he has that scorch can. He's like, ba-boo, 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 and that's it. That's all he has.
And drinks orange
that
soda.
That is true.
You, know how to fix, how to fix the boss fights in that? Stop making them ads. Don't make them ad boss fights.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah, stop doing that. No one likes ads. They're just so annoying.
What's unique about Oryx, he looks like a knight class mixed with, like, a wizard. Because he has his wizard form, and then he has his big buff, like, wing spread out sort of form with his sword. So I'm like, I feel like we're probably going to fight the wizard form of him. I'm pretty sure he's gonna change it up, definitely. I feel he's gonna change
it's
it
probably
up.
It's probably gonna be like a stage fight, like.
Because he has different stages of his evolve. So, like, I'm pretty sure in the stories, he's gonna be in, like, wizard form, and then when you're on the ship with him, he's in full, like, knight mode.
He's just a misunderstood butterfly. He just wants to fly around, everyone's just like, ah! Then they kill his son, and he's like, oh, you guys suck.
Killed his metamorphosis.
You guys.
Yeah, he had to get out of his cocoon.
Salty now.
Yeah,
man, I just gotta kill all Earth, because, you know. Don't know what else to do now.
Exactly.
Did he ever say that he's gonna kill Earth? Because no one ever said that. They said that he's just coming for you. Like, if you just went, like, I did it, and he kills you.
A bunch
of
revenge.
Is that gonna be the end
of it? No, you as in.
He gave Crota that sword on his birthday.
Okay.
How would Eris know what this guy's doing? Did he, like, just text her, be like, yo, I'm pissed? I'm very angry.
Maybe texting back and forth. She's like,
back and forth. They're secretly dating. That's why she has no eyes. So she's like, I can't look at this.
No, she's like, yo, this dude killed your son. He's like, that's fucked up, dude.
He's like, that's messed up.
I think I'm right now.
Oryx just penetrated like her with his sword.
The Squirtle couldn't go deep enough, so
That's how. How do you think? Who do you think's Crota's mom is.
It's Eris.
Now, that'd be a plot twist. She's just chilling right in the tower watching all the guardians pass by her.
She's not watching anything. She
it's
has
actually
a
just, it's actually just one big space vagina.
God damn. He penetrated the darkness.
Alright, we're getting off.
There you go!
Oh my god.
Oh gosh. You think Oryx is gonna be the end of the darkness, though? Because he is. I mean, the Hive is definitely the darkness incarnate.
He's the king, but
the
one
king.
The end.
What I really want to see, and it can honestly be a cliffhanger, quite honestly, if that's how it's supposed to work out, then so be it. I want to see how big of an impact the Nine are.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they're going to do that sometime.
I
want to
say they're like the Illuminati of Destiny. They're
right.
Pulling their strings. I want to say, I'm just
Illuminati,
pure speculation.
The architects.
Right to the architects.
So I don't know. Maybe Oryx is just another pawn in all this. As crazy as that sounds,
we'll see.
I don't know. Maybe the Nine is actually.
We'll see in 10 years when they decide to tell the entire story.
Give another 5 years, we might see another plot.
But jumping back, he's not going to be the end of the darkness because with this type of story. There's always darkness and there's always light. There's always these two opposing forces. So no matter how far you get, or like how much of the darkness you get rid of, there's always going to be some left. It's like, look at any other story. Think Star Wars, for example.
And
there's never just the dark side and there's never just the light side.
Well, why would they end the darkness at the beginning of year two?
Yeah, you're right.
What are you doing?
That's just bad management on their part.
It honestly sounds like they're just making this up as they go anyway. So
that is true.
Yeah.
They could have.
I mean, if they release their trailer and then like a week later they're like, we changed the game.
Now it's gonna be sweet and sour or something like that, you know.
You see, like the most epic raid to me. There's gonna be another raid too because there's gameplay of Vex Boss.
That's probably going to be a strike, not a raid.
Okay, yeah, that'll probably be a strike.
I saw some of the bosses for the strikes, they look...
Yeah, like the,
the Hive dude has the giant axe.
Yeah, the Hive guy, there's the Cabal general who has, like, a giant bubble shield, and...
I don't know why, he reminded me of a Transformer. The Cabal guy.
He had
like,
a giant...
Oh, it's Megatron! I don't know.
There's going to be a lot of... There's going to be new Vex bosses too, and there's going to be just the Taken... And the dynamic with their attacks and everything, it's gonna be like a really new experience. We're gonna feel all the new enemies and the differences that they have, which I'm pretty glad to see about. All right, but thank you guys for listening to us. This has been Thoughts of Nerds with a collab with IcyShadows and CringeOfDespair and
Jacobo.
Jacobo,
all the lonely hobo.
Revealed.
Jacobo,
all
right. Thank you guys.
You're a hobo now. That's lore.
Thank you guys for dealing with our madness and listening to us going about Destiny. We're excited for Taken King. Skip for Scott because he doesn't play it. So
it depends. If I see you guys playing it and it looks decent, then I may, like, after a few years.
Well, just wait till, like, just wait 10 years later when the Ultra Mega, like, combo comes out. And it's higher 10 years for $60!
Exactly. Like, all DLC.
Dude, by then, the graphics are gonna be terrible. It's like, what is this?
Yeah, I know, for real. Like, that's what I was gonna... All right,
that's gonna be, like, the one game from this generation that doesn't hold up, all the others do.
Yeah, that's alright. Thank you guys so much for watching. Catch us next time. Peace out.
Bye.
See ya.
Bye.